همشي إيشن بدينا دار لينزي أي سيسة لتربط كمع إنجن أخلي إنسمعتين أولو so Donald you've got quite an interesting thing going on with the instrument making
I do yeah
I heard tell us about it
well I've been working on two main instruments mm-hmm. The first is my own chanter for the small pipes which is an extended range chanter it plays the standard scale mm-hmm. Is the core of its range, but it'll go down the way to a low D and up to a high D as well.
And right.
Play some notes, some semitones in the scale, same semitones you get in the border pipes. So it plays with quite a few extra notes. And I've got my low whistle as well, which I'm calling the whistle, which is just a nice thick sounding low whistle I've been working on.
Yeah, so you've paint your instruments.
I do, yes. I got into 3D printing after spending a few years making prototypes from scratch in various ways and taking these to see if pipe makers thought they were makeable, which usually they didn't. And then when I came back to Glasgow in 2013, I saw a flyer for MacLab. So I went down to MacLab and spent hours learning how to use the thing and standing over it. So come the spring of 2014, I ran a Kickstarter and raised the funds to have a printer at home. So I've been I've been wearing that printer out ever since.
I bet. And what materials do you print your instruments out of?
PLA is cornstarch based, so it's slightly more recyclable and so on.
Okay.
ABS is a wee bit easier to hand finish. So
how do you find that these materials compare with like wood or traditionally made with?
Tonally, I find that they are actually 3D printed plastics are actually quite a good comparison with wood. Now, I've got my own ideas about why this is. Nobody has a definitive answer, of course, about materials when it comes to instruments.
Mm-hmm.
But I think the reason for... I perceive a distinct difference in the sound of a 3D printed plastic over a moulded plastic. Or a machine plastic,
mm-hmm.
and I think that this is because the way the printing process works, it lays down layer by layer wee strings of plastic, and those wee strings of plastic, they don't completely fuse together, they stick together, but there's wee gaps
mm-hmm.
all the way through the piece, a little bit like grain in a piece of wood, and so when you wrap them on the table, you notice that they sound woody.
Right.
So they've got a little bit of a hollow note,
right.
Whereas usually a solid Delrin piece will just have a kind of a thunk sort of a sound.
Yeah.
They've got a more of a musical sound to them.
Right. And for anyone out there that wants to know,
yeah.
Big question, where can they buy them?
Well, the whistles you can get through my site, linstruments.com, and I'm making them with machined bodies and 3D printed heads, and the bodies come in plastic or aluminium now. So you've got your choice of plastic or aluminium whistles, and there is a slight sound difference between plastic and aluminium, as most whistlers will know.
Mm-hmm.
They can be got online. The chanters, you'll also find them there, although I'm actually about to put a waiting list notice on the chanters because
you better get in quick then.
There is a wee bit of a lead time at the moment on chanters and pipes.
Great. Well, sounds great.
Thank you very much, Alana.
No problem. Thanks for chatting to me.
You're
Cheers with us.